It'll cost us money, not much.
Okay.
The prisoners need books for the library.
Danny, we already discussed that. I told him he could get the books as donations.
No, I know, but I was speaking with Caputo.
Who's Caputo? Our man on the ground.
And what department is he in?
He's in the prison, working there. Anyway, he was thinking it would be important for the inmates to get legal books to work in their cases. Also, we haven't talked at all about implementing a job training program.
And the idea behind job training is
to help the prisoners get jobs after they get out of prison.
Probably should wait till Jones gets back to talk about that.
Yeah, that's more of an outreach issue. That's not really operational.
I don't know when else I'd bring it up.
Well, I think it's a nice idea, but sounds like something for a little further down the road.
That's all for today. Thank you, everybody. Hey, Cheryl, can you go talk to Edward in HR?
We're fired?
He'll walk you through it.
Okay.
What was that all about? The one day Strath is here for Atlanta.
There are issues we need to deal with now, or it's gonna cost us way more down the road. I mean, this stuff with kosher meals, I mean, you might be saving dollars and cents, but what if there's a lawsuit?
You think Strath gives a shit? He's gonna be running some other corporation before anything comes to bite him in the ass. What he wants and needs is something he can show his shareholders at the end of this quarter.
I know. But isn't there any big picture here? And Caputo and I are the only ones on the floor dealing with these things face to face.
Because you're good with people. If I wanted someone with sucking people skills, I would have hired your sister. Working in a women's prison doesn't mean you have to act like a woman. You get my drift?
Yeah, I get it, Dad.
It's all right. It's a process. But remember, you're the boss,
Right?
not Mr. Caputo.
Yes.
Who's the boss?
I'm the boss.
That's right.
I brought you some pictures of the house, but I wasn't allowed to bring them in. I can describe it to you that way.
Oh, it's all right. I know you're nervous and all, but you should know that I still want you to have a baby.
Well, that's. But I got one condition. I want you to write to me. Not all the time, because I know you'll be busy with her and your life and everything. I just want to know that she's okay since I can't visit, because it wouldn't be good for her, so.
You keep saying her. Do you know it's a girl?
No. My mother thinks she is, so, you know, because the way my belly hangs.
Diane. Of course I'll write to you. That was always part of the plan. And I will send you some of her drawings so you can see if she inherited your artistic talents.
Aww.
Because George, he can't even draw a straight line. I mean, good runner, though. Very athletic. How much will he be involved?
Well, he is in prison, so not much.
I'm really glad that you thought this through, because when you said but, I was afraid.
What?
I was afraid you were going to ask for more money.
More money?
The arrangement with your mother. She didn't tell you.
No, she didn't tell me.
I'm happy to pay you a little stipend if it helps you get back on your feet.
No, this isn't right.
Dayanara, I have the means, and I really want to help you and your mother. I mean, we're family now, so it's okay.
All my mother cares about is getting paid. I can't do this. This is a lie.
Wait, what do you mean?
The baby is in George's. But he, yeah, I had sex with him. Well, he had sex with me. We had sex, but it isn't his. I was already pregnant, but that really doesn't matter. Well, I just wanted what was best for the baby, and you seem kind, and the life you could give her is a life that I want her to have, so it's like... I can't lie. I can't lie for money. I'm sorry. I feel so sick right now. You got it. God bless America.
You know, Benny's at our house for dinner tonight.
Yeah?
I guess they're really becoming friends.
Wow, that must be hard on you. Seeing as your son is so impressionable and mine uses such crass language.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have accused you.
No, you shouldn't have.
It's just that I was hoping I could be there to help shape him, you know. Teach him how to shave or change a tire. I might have changed, but I'm still his father.
And how do you think I feel? I'm supposed to be taking care of shit. Worst thing I could imagine is my son becoming a thug. But he could. And I can't stop him.
Fuck you, man.
It's done. Now, you should know, the story took an unexpected turn during the trial by lovemaking. Edwina Lionel. In no one membrane from another.
What? Who did she choose? Oh, man.
Don't blame me. I'm but a lowly instrument to the muses.
Those meals aren't fit for human consumption.
That's not true, and you'll get used to them. This is the same meals that they serve in all the prisons in the country.
Is that supposed to make me feel better? Here, don't get me wrong. I knew there would be compromises, and I'd love being forced to improvise. But I can't play the piano if you cut off my hands and wrists.
I don't know what to tell you now. I've already gone out on a limb for you. You can't just jump from job to job as you please.
It's killing me.
I'm sorry, Red. My hands are cut off, too. Red. Red. Jack. Stink cigarettes, I smell their clothes. What can I do for you?
I talked to So-So earlier today. You wrote her a recommendation to get on the antidepressants?
Yeah, she was feeling blue.
Well, I don't think it's a good idea to jump right to medication, at least not before talking through the problem.
I did talk through the problem, and I decided to take action before things got worse.
He also told her nobody likes sad people and that depression's all in her head.
So?
When someone's feeling vulnerable, they need their pain acknowledged, not be made to feel worse for having it.
Well, look, no offense to you, but she's my counselee, and I don't need to take advice from someone like you.
Someone like me?
I have a master's in social work.
And I have a master's in psychology. The last thing I want is to step on your toes.